Anyone who's been down there and walked the open fairways and enjoyed the golf knows how good our golfers are. And the one thing we're very proud of is that there are equal numbers following the men and women. And the spectators love the fact that they can watch one group of women, one group of men, and actually compare each other and compare themselves to that. And what we find, the feedback is that it's an enjoyable experience, but they love the fact that it's an equal footing. They're playing for the same money. And, you know, the number of women from the US Tour who played last year was outstanding. And I think that the playoff with Mel Reid and Sandra Gale just proved the level we're getting to in a little country town in Victoria, all the way on the other side of the world.
Well, that's what I was going to say, and it's not to denigrate the men's field at all, but Sandra Gale versus Mel Reid, that could be any major championship, you know, shootout in the last round.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I think that's a testament to the tournament. They came out here because of, and what I think golf's very good at, and I don't want to harp on the female side, but they're very, very important. It's that area we need to grow, and we've touched on that. But they spread the word. I mean, we have Ali, we have Stacey Keating, we have Beck Artis, and all these great female pros who are Australian. They're telling everyone around the world, come down and play this event. It's fun. And I go back to my earlier point that statistics are telling us now if we want to get into the game, it should be fun. And that's actually what that shows. The girls and the guys come down, and Hazy, you've been there, Ali's commentated, Mari, you've been involved. I don't think there's anyone, even if you missed the cut, you've probably still had fun. Yeah. And that's an important thing.